We raise our bumblebees in a walk-in growth chamber in the basement of the building. We have temperature control, we have humidity control, so we can maintain the conditions at the optimal level for bumblebees. We also have a red light, and bees don't see very well in red light, so it allows us to work with them without disturbing them too much. Hi, my name is Tobin Hammer. I'm an assistant professor in the Ecology and Evolutionary Biology department at UC Irvine. My lab works on the microbiome of bees, and we're interested in who these microbes are, how they interact with bees, their roles in bee health, and also their evolutionary history. We want to know where they came from and why bees have the microbes that they have today. We use DNA sequencing to understand what microbes are present in, mainly in their guts. And then we use bioinformatics to understand who these microbes are and what they're doing inside of bees. There's two different reasons why studying the microbiomes of bees is important. One of which is that bees can serve as a great model for understanding the human gut microbiome. There's actually a lot of parallels between the microbiome of bees and of humans. And so we can learn a lot about the kind of the principles of how microbiomes work, how they influence host health in bees, and then ultimately translate that to potentially improve human health. The second reason is we're interested in supporting bees and the pollination services they provide, which are really crucial for wild plants and also for many of the crops that we eat. And so by studying the microbiome of bees and their roles in bee health, we can potentially translate that into actions that may support bee health in their bipollination.